Yo, what's up guys, this goes in today's video, guys, back with another Grand Cross video. So this video is going to be about it's basically a before you summon or should you summon kind of video. I always do this with new units that do come out to global version, and as well as JP whenever that happens. But for global version right now, currently, of course, you can see Helbrim on the screen right now. I do want to talk about him and basically just talk about if he is a good unit to have, if he's worth summoning for, and so on. So one thing to note is this unit itself came out with King. This Green King is super good for the Gray Demon. He's actually meant for the Gray Demon. So having these two banners is actually really good. Now, whenever this banner first came out, I think it was Helbrim, I believe by himself, if I remember correctly on JP. If not, let me know in the comments below. But when Green King came out on a banner again, he was with a Green Bond. Green Bond, which I believe is in the game currently. I don't think I pulled him though yet. This green bond, he came out with this unit. So of course it's a little bit different, but it's nice to see that they're bringing out Helbrim finally. So he's good for PvP, right? So the reason why he's good for PvP is because this unit itself can take away ultimate gauges depending on the stars that you use. So a 2-star can take away 1, right? 3-star can take away 3 ultimate gauges, and it does pretty decent damage for being a red type unit. But it's mainly because taking away ultimate gauge is very crucial when it comes to PvP. Now, mainly his focus on it is going to be the petrify. So he also petrifies just like the Blue King. Blue King also allows him to petrify. So having another unit that petrifies is very good, especially in PvP, which you're going to see the term called Kingbrum now. So Kingbrum is going to be what you will start using basically, because if you pull this unit, Kingbrum is going to be alive for you. So he petrifies it for 2 turns as well for a 3-star, and then 2-star he does it for 1 turn. So being that this unit is going to be able to petrify, you're going to need a specific unit. Now, one thing to note is if you go into the shop, right, because I'll get back to the Helbrim, if you go into the coin shop and you see this Gother, this is not the Gother to get. Guys, this is the blue Gother. You want to get the red Gother. So red Gother currently right now is still out in the game in the in his banner. His banner leaves the 14th. Today is the recording of the 7th, so he leaves in 1 week exactly. This is the one that will go into the coin shop after Merlin is added, and then Gother will be added. So this unit currently is of course still in a banner. You want to have this unit with this red Helbrim, right? I'm going to talk about the teams just to confirm that, but just to get you guys like fully up to date with this, Helbrim is going to be really, really good for PvP. Other than that, everything else I don't think he's really useful for, because he's mainly pushed for PvP base. So one good thing about him as well is that when you do his ultimate allows you to cancel buffs and stances. So that's going to be very helpful, especially in PvP. And then he attacks all enemies. You have one with Gustav, which is going to do more damage. So if you have Gustav, you can put him as his sub partner and you'll get that boost as well. Now to talk about his passive, I don't have his passive here, obviously, but I think if I go into the characters, it should show. I believe it does. So let me go here. Yeah, so I can click it right here. So this increases basic stats by 5% per each surviving ally. So the more allies you have, the more basic stats this unit gets. So of course you want to have more surviving, you'll get more boost, and that's pretty much how it goes. So you can see his stats right here. His pierce rate's only 20%, resistance is 20%, his crit damage is 150%. So expect to see some pretty decent critical attacks whenever you use this card. So that's really good as well. So from there, I mean, this unit's very, very good for PvP. Unfortunately, I don't have him yet. I did like 3 multis. I'll show you guys the multis if you guys want to watch those. I'll just put it on the side. But yeah, that's basically that for this unit. Now, the thing is, this banner is trash. This banner is a copy and paste for every single banner that has come out on global yet so far. They just add on the new unit, that's it. So you can see Green King and the Helbrim are rated up units basically, but you have all the other units in this banner that are the same units since every other banner has came out. So it's all the same, nothing new, nothing different. Like, there's no 7 Deadly Sins units in here. So this is where it's going to matter. Should you summon for this unit? Personally, if you are a PvP junkie, you love to play PvP all the time, and you want to be toxic, you want to go for this unit. Now, if you are one of those where they just like to play PvP here and there and you don't mind, and you're probably already at Champion 5 in PvP, then you don't have to go for this unit. If you want to play PvP, then go for this unit. It's all based on if you like to play PvP. Other than that, I personally am not going to go too crazy on the banner. I did like 3 multis just because I wanted to see if I pulled him for collection base, and I really was going for the king, to be honest. If I'm gonna be honest with you, yeah, king is the one that I was going for. So the thing is, this Helbrum is a good unit for sure, right? He petrifies, that's another good thing. Like, there's only two units that does petrify, this and the blue king, right? So that's really nice to know. Now the thing is, you have units that will probably be coming out later on, probably in the week or two, right, that will come out, and I'm gonna switch to GC database to talk about it more so you guys can understand a little bit better. So when we go into GC database, right, I have Escanor up right now. I'm assuming Escanor probably will come out within the next week or so, and this is what's gonna matter. If you're going to be running Gother, Helbrum, and King, right, these three units are the King-Brum combo that are going to be really, really toxic in global PvP right now. So the thing is, you can have one other unit that will probably be super helpful against this team is going to be Gallant. So Gallant can be helpful against this team just because he can, of course, attack everyone. He can also have his commandment up, which is going to allow the unit to basically get petrified, which is Gother, obviously, because he's the one who ranks up the cards. So Gother has still a counter, which is Gallant. And then, of course, having a unit that can do a lot of damage, fighting, especially a blue type unit, fighting Helbrum, which is a red type unit, you still have the advantage with Gallant. So you can go ahead and attack with Gallant mainly on Helbrum, so you can get rid of Helbrum pretty fast. Now, the thing is, you have to be careful because King still can heal. So you have to be very careful on how you do that. Because if you're fighting a King, you have to make sure you have a unit that can counter King, basically. Someone that can, like, deal a lot of damage, right? So you can technically run a unit like, let's just say, Jericho. You could run Green Jericho, because she could be a unit that you can do a lot of damage with. Or you can have a team that's mainly focusing on damaging. So if you have, Gother as well. If you pulled Gother, for example, you have Gallant, for example, and you have the Red Arthur. The Red Arthur will allow you to get those boosts, right? Because Arthur's a really good unit. Like, he's actually super good to have for PvP right now because of this basic boost, and then as well as a rank 3 debuff, which is really good. So he removes debuffs on all allies. Basic stats are at 30% and grants debuff immunity for 3 turns. So you can use something like this as a combo, but just make sure, like, you have to have a 3-star of this card if you're using a Gother, because Gother will get petrified from Gallant, so you have to be careful with that. But Helbrum is going to be a good unit for PvP because he can petrify, and if you have another petrify unit with King, because he can also petrify, you have 2 units that can petrify your enemy, and then your enemy can only attack once, basically, because they only have 1 turn to attack with. I think it's actually, they should be able to attack 3 times, obviously, but with 1 character only, so you can basically, nerf the whole like turn, basically. So with Gother and Helbrum and King, that's going to be really, really toxic team that you can run, but it's only if you play PvP. So if you don't play PvP and you're not worrying about that, then do not worry about it. Personally, I'm going to say right now, Escanor probably will be coming out in the next update, which is chapter 8 update, and this unit is going to be the counter to Gallant. And Gallant is one of the best units to have right now in PvP, but this unit is going to take over. It just does a lot of damage because, one, he's a green type unit. Two, he does a lot of damage from his 1-star skill, and he fills up his ultimate gauge, and he ults really, really fast and really strong. Like, his attacks are really strong. And then, of course, his passive, once he gets to his full ultimate gauge, he removes buffs and debuffs when the hero's ultimate move gauge is completely filled, grants debuff immunity. So basically, this passive right there is literally Arthur's 3-star card, basically. Except the basic stats boost, but that's just crazy. Like, this Escanor is gonna be the unit to have. So, like I'm saying, skip Helbrum, right? Don't summon for him, and then go for Escanor. Mainly the reason why is because, one, they are probably gonna come right back to each other. And Helbrum, if you're PvP base and you don't mind spending gems, then yeah, go for both of them if you really want to. But skip Helbrum. I only want to do like 3 multis just for collector's reasons, just to see if I pull this Helbrum or if I pull the Green King, because I need the Green King. But I mean, other than that, I'm not really going for him. Just know that he is going to be really good with a team like King and Gother, because this is going to be the King-Brum combo. But for that is all for this video. I am going to specifically say skip this banner wait until you have Escanor in a banner. And I know a lot of you guys are saving for him, so hopefully you guys do pull him. But for Gother, this red Gother will be put into the coin shop sometime soon. For now, do not do anything with this blue Gother, because a lot of people will get confused and assume that this is the Gother that's out. No, this is not the Gother you should be getting. Do not go for this unit. But that's pretty much for this video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. If you guys have any kind of questions, let me know in the comments below. This banner leaves on the 14th, so it's only here for a week. And guess what? In 1 week, you're going to see that this banner leaves as well. And if we're not with a banner for, I think, a week or two, then I don't know how it's going to go. But when that update comes, I'm assuming Escanor will be coming out with, if possible, Red Demon Meliodas. If possible. If that does happen, that is the banner to summon for. But I don't know how, you know, Global's going to do it. But that's just a theory of what they're going to do. But hopefully you guys did enjoy. Drop a like on this video if you guys are brand new. You know, subscribe, of course, and all that good stuff. Now, I do want to talk about other things in another video. I'm going to talk about another part whenever I do get to that. The Hawk Pass is something I do want to talk about when that comes out for the video. You guys see that later on today. And then this grinding out information, if you go to the exchange items, I want to talk about all the stuff that's in here as well. So once I get to that, I will talk to you guys about that on another video later on today. So if you guys are going to enjoy that, let me know in the comments below. If you guys have any kind of questions, if you guys need any help, let me know. I'll do my best for that. But that's going to do it for today's video, guys. Have a great day.